Welcome back to another game of Mlb The Show 16 on the Sony PlayStation 3. Okay, so let's go with stamina, velocity, control, sinker. I'll bump that up to 50. Bump this up to 50. Velocity is a curveball. Let's bump that up by 2. Wow, look at, I'm the only pitcher in Double A with 8-1, 8-1, 85 in the third inning, 7. I only gave up 7 error runs, 140 strikeouts. That's insane numbers to look at. That's why I decided that, like, hey, look, I'm going to pump in as much. I have to put more stamina. More stamina?
Welcome back to our minor league pregame show as we move closer to the start of Eastern League action with tonight's installment of the Bowman Prospect Spotlight. Number 25 is our man to watch. As he put together a month to remember. You can see there on the screen, his output has been nothing short of dominant.
4-0. Pretty much I was like probably pitcher of the month. Oh, I'm playing against my team. Okay, man, see? My K ratio way up there. 2 times him.
Jose Machado comes to the plate to lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
See how much easier this is than your 93.
Take a look at our visitors as they enter play here this evening. They've been on a pretty good roll of late, winners of 7 of their last 8 ball games.
Yeah, when you're playing good baseball, first place starts coming into clearer focus. It really made up some ground here this past week or so.
Got him swinging on the split finger pitch, and that's out number 1.
Whoa!
The scouting report for tonight's starter. As you see, the pitches he'll rely on as the night moves forward.
96 to 101, they're saying that my fastball can go up to. I'm not quite sure about that, but we'll see.
On the fastball that time, out number 2.
Yeah, make it back-to-back strikeouts here to start the inning. So much for the top of the lineup set to take.
a swing and a ground ball. And that swung on and fouled straight back. And the pitch. And a sinker there, swung on and missed for out number three. Three up, three down, three strikeouts. Not too shabby.
Wow, we're winning one another. I didn't even know that. See how much easier this game is to pitch in? This game is way easier.
And a splitter here, but he had a bit too much on it as this bounces up to the plate. And this is popped foul off to the right and back into the seats.
That was a good curveball right there. I'm using all my pitches. Hundred miles an hour.
Either you take that leg kick completely out of the equation, or you get it started just a little bit quicker. Well, it's been something of a.
It's the first time I've seen
this. Start this game off. Already four strikeouts now in the first five batters. Now that's going to be a tough pace to keep up.
Standing in now, Doug Brennan. As he takes a cold strike at the knees, it's 0-1.
Split fingers are really good to go against the left right-handers more.
And he is in complete control now. seven strikeouts as this is swung on and missed for the second out.
Well, right now he is just carving them up, dare I say, like a Thanksgiving turkey. That's seven strikeouts already, and he's made it look easy so far.
He swings and pops it high in the air out towards shallow right. Blasmill will put this one away, and the side is retired.
And that is why I added the split finger for a reason. Because like his right hand is very effective, more than on the lefties.
A lot of these guys have come into these at-bats trying to be the aggressor, trying to make something happen. But what has happened is that they've swung and missed themselves into some early holes.
Throw in time as he's called out on a bang-bang play at first. Well, as he falls behind nothing and two.
And you'd think, for as hot as this guy's been over the last few games, they might be treading carefully. They're coming right after him, and now they've got him in an 0-2 hole.
And they'll try to tempt him with a curveball, but this bounces in front of the plate, and it's 1-2. Oh, he can't come up with it. And they'll wind up with no play here as he reaches first safely.
Freaking kidding me, man? Just wanted to run out there.
First guy, Brennan, is at the plate now. Fly out at his first at bat. Now a ball grounded foul over toward the coaching box. Swing and a miss, it's 0-2.
And you know what, guys? I have been really impressed so far. Not only has he used his fastball well, but he's also spotted it well. I mean, that is perfect location right on the knees.
And this is fouled back and out of play. Another 0-2 coming, and a breaking ball in the dirt that time for a ball. And a ball popped foul to the right side, out of play. And here's a ball hit in the air, and this is going to wind up a foul ball. Now a 58-foot curveball that misses for a ball. Struck him out, his eighth punch out of the ball game, and that one ends the inning. One error. Richie Boyce comes to the plate as we get started here in the bottom of the fifth. And this is low, ball one. Swing and a high pop-up straight back, though it looks as though he'll have room back there. And he's retired one away. Marcus O'Neill comes to the plate looking to put the ball in play. He went down on strikes last time.
Ball one.
Now a little pop-up off toward the third base side. And no one will get this one. No contact there, and it's 1-2.
Boy, he is putting on a clinic out there right now. These guys don't know what to look for.
Pitch on the way. And he pops him up over toward foul territory. And this will land foul. Now another 1-2. And he punches out another one. Make it 9 for the ball game.
Sometimes this is all you have to do. Throw a ton of strikes and keep the ball in the yard. Worked for him so far.
Jason Madden is into the box. Strikeout victim in his first try. And this is taken outside for ball one. Swing and a miss as he ramps up on a fastball, 1-1. Bases are empty here with two men out. Grounded foul off to the right and over toward the dugout. And he will strike him out. 10 now in the ballgame, and the inning is over. 5 innings have been no problem as he's got the shutout. in now to start things out here in their half of the sixth as they look for a reversal of fortunes here. The first five innings have not been particularly kind to them.
Yeah, I think that's pretty good. Just one hit in these first five innings, they're going to need to do a better job of finding good pitches to hit. But that fellow on the mound has not made it easy on him, and that's for sure.
Split-fingered pitch that's by him for strike two. Now a little tapper here up the first baseline. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Struck him out as his woes continue, as that's his third strikeout of the game.
Ouch. That's a rough night at the ballpark here. Third strikeout. One thing you can't do, though, you can't go into that dugout hanging your head. You got to think, hey, it's over. I'll get another shot to redeem myself. Whether that's tonight or sometime in the future, that's the attitude you have to have.
Right-hander starts to loosen out from the bullpen now. Brad Luckett is in for the third time as he looks at a ball high. It's 1-0. Sneaks a fastball by him at the letters. It's 1-1.
And that has been the comfort zone so far in this outing. He's just lived on that outside corner, and it's paid big dividends for him.
He's just rolling right now, and even doesn't strike out.
The curveball threw him off.
And I tell you, I like the way he's handling himself out there. Going after guys, he's working ahead in the count, he's keeping the ball around the plate. All the things you want to see in a young pitcher.
That's because I'm the best pitcher in all of Double-A.
In the ball game so far. And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1. He continues to get ahead here. He's been in complete control.
I think you need to guard yourself from being overconfident, though. A bloop and a blast can still turn this game on its ear.
Waved at and missed, and he's behind 0-2.
And this is part of why he's had a lot of success so far. Done a lot of work on the edges and stayed out of the middle of the strike.
A splitter, but he started it too low as it bounces up to the plate. And this is fouled back and out of play. Two out, nobody on. Foul back. One-two pitch here is a routine grounder to third. Throw in time and the side is retired. Make it six shutout innings.
Yeah, you need a curveball, but not too much because the control on it is not as good.
And this is going to be a foul ball. Right by him here. He's set up for another strikeout here. The count to 0-2.
But I'll tell you, to be down 0-2 against a guy like this, with the stuff he's got tonight, not a comfortable spot to be in.
And his 0-2 is bounced on the ground to third. And he's set down, one away.
Now batting, designated
hitter, Luis Mendoza. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Luis Mendoza stands in for the third time now as he takes a look at a ball. It's 1-0. Ball hit pretty well out toward left center. Will range to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the second out of the inning. Doug Brannon will stand in now. He flew out in his first time around and then was a strikeout victim last time. Oh, had him chopping at that one. It's nothing and one.
And this is becoming a theme now. It's part of why he's been so successful out there so far. Let these guys chase that first pitch and get him in a hole right away.
Can't get him to chase. It's 1-2. Bases are empty here with two men out. There's a drive high in the air and deep to left center field.
Punch out of the freaking face.
So a solo shot here to left center field as they cut the lead in half. It's 2-1 now.
I'm not freaking happy about that.
Thumb, the ball and a strike. And a pitch misses blowing away for ball two.
I'm not happy I gave up a freaking home run. That's not good enough. Now I'm 9-1, 92 in the third innings, 14 hits, 6 base walks, 152 strikeouts, a stinking 0.78 ERA. I'm not happy about that. Let's compare. That's still better than the pitcher in the majors. Pitcher in the majors still haven't got what I got. I got 152 strikeouts. I'm literally less than 50 pitches away from getting 200 strikeouts in the minor league system. That's insane. This guy who pitches for us, he's 297. This one is 277. And Castillo, Diego. Pretty much our pitching staff is pretty decent. Oh wow, this guy is just as good as I am. And then me, I pitch on the 8th. I'm the best record though, but the second best guy is him. He's probably the second ace behind me. Alrighty guys, I want to thank you guys for watching. I'm going to be the show 16 on the PlayStation 3. Like and subscribe, and also don't forget to press the notification bell to let you know when I upload. And see you guys next time. Bye guys!